We shall revise the lesson A Feat on Feet. But before we start, let me just quickly tell you a short summary of what is there in the lesson so you can remember what this lesson teaches us. Okay, now Edmund Hillary and Tenzing Norgay were part of the British expedition or the epic journey to Mount Everest, which happened in the year 1953. Colonel John Hunt led the expedition. He selected a team of experienced climbers, of which Edmund Hillary from New Zealand and Tenzing Norgay, a Sherpa, or a skilled mountaineer from India, were both a part of. After months of planning and preparation, finally, only four climbers were selected. These four climbers were divided into two teams. The first team included Tom Bourdillon and Charles Evans, while Edmund Hillary and Tenzing Norgay made up the second team. The first team left on May 26, 1953 to reach the summit or top of Mount Everest. They were almost near, but they were forced to turn back as they faced bad weather. On May 29, 1953, Edmund Hillary and Tenzing Norgay set out for their climb to the top of Mount Everest at 6:30 a.m. and reached it at 11:30 a.m. As they reached there, they hugged each other out of happiness and joy and stayed there for 15 minutes as their oxygen supply was very low. They took photographs and enjoyed the view, and at the end of their 15 minutes made their way back down to the mountains. Well, now that your memory is all brushed up, we shall now do some questions and answers and exercises together. First, I shall read out all the questions for you and then I shall discuss them with you. Some questions I shall ask you to do on your own, but if I feel that some of them are a little difficult, I shall discuss them with you. Answer the following questions with reference to the context. Reference number one. Out of all the climbers on the expedition, only four would get a chance to make an attempt to reach the summit. Question one to this reference is, which lesson is this line taken from? Number two, which expedition is referred to here? Number three, how many climbers were selected in the team at first? Number four, who selected the team? And how many teams were finally selected? This question has two parts, so we will while discussing, I will give you the answers accordingly. Number five, name the team members of the two teams respectively. So first you will read the reference very carefully and then you will answer the questions. Out of all the climbers on the expedition, only four would get a chance to make an attempt to reach the summit. Question number one. Which lesson is this line taken from? This line is taken from the lesson A Feat on Feet. Number two. Which expedition is referred to here? The British expedition to Mount Everest of 1953 is referred to here. Number three. How many climbers were selected in the team at first? Answer. 11 climbers were selected in the team at first. Edmund Hillary and Tenzing Norgay were among them. Number four. Who selected the team? How many teams were finally selected? So this question has two parts. The answer to part one is Colonel John Hunt selected the team, and the answer to part two is finally two teams were selected. Question number five. Name the team members of the two teams respectively. The first team included Tom Bodilon and Charles Evans, while Edmund Hillary and Tenzing Norgay made up the second team. Okay, now reference number two. They spent their time taking photographs and enjoying the view. Again, I shall first read out the questions for you and then we will discuss them one by one. Number one, which lesson is this line taken from? Number two, who are referred to as they here? Number three, from where did they enjoy the view and take photographs? Number four, state the date and time of their arrival at this place. And number five, how much time did they spend there? Why did they spend only that much time there? Again, this question also has two parts. So read the line carefully before answering the questions. They spent their time taking photographs and enjoying the view. The first question to this reference is, which lesson is this line taken from? This line is taken from the lesson, A Feet on Feet. Question number two, who are referred to as they here? Edmund Hillary and Tenzing Norgay are referred to as they here. Question number three, from where did they enjoy the view and take photographs? Answer, they enjoyed the view and took photographs from the top of Mount Everest. Question number four, state the date and time of their arrival at this place. Answer, they reached the summit of Mount Everest at 11:30 a.m. on May 29, 1953. Question number five, how much time did they spend there? And why did they spend only that much time there? So this question, it has two parts. So first I will tell you the answer to part one and then I will tell you the answer to part two. The answer to part one is, they spent only 15 minutes there. And the answer to part two is, they enjoyed only 15 minutes there as they had a very low supply of oxygen. Now we shall do another set of questions. Answer the following question. Again, in the similar manner, first I will read out the questions to you and then we shall discuss them one by one. Question number one. Write about the experience of the first team that set out to reach the summit of Mount Everest. Number two, write a short note on Edmund Hillary. Okay, answer to these questions are, number one, write about the experience of the first team that set out to reach the summit of Mount Everest. Answer, the first team that included Tom Bodilon and Charles Evans left on May 26th, 1953 to reach the summit of Mount Everest. They successfully made it to the South Summit, the first ascent of 8,750 meters, coming within 100 meters of the final top, still the highest any human being had ever reached. However, they were forced to return back as they faced bad weather problems with their oxygen canister and lack of time. They were also really very tired. Question number two. Write a short note on Edmund Hillary. Answer. Sir Edmund Percival Hillary was a New Zealand mountaineer, explorer and philanthropist. A philanthropist is a person who seeks to promote the welfare of other people, especially by donating money for good causes. On 29th May 1953, Hillary and Sherpa mountaineer Tenzing Norgay became the first climbers to have reached the summit of Mount Everest. They were a part of the 9th British expedition to Everest. He was born on 20th July 1919. He was knighted in 1953. Many other honors were bestowed on him, throughout which he maintained a high level of humility and his main interest came to be the welfare of the Himalayan people of Nepal, especially the Sherpas. He built schools and hospitals and airfields for them. And in 2003, he was made the honorary citizen of Nepal. He died at the age of 88 on January 11th, 2008. Okay, so now we shall do another set of questions. Again, I shall first read out the questions for you and then we shall discuss them one by one. If I feel any of them is difficult, I shall discuss the answers and the rest I'll tell you, which you will do on your own. Answer the following questions in one or two sentences. Number one, which is the highest mountain peak in the world? Number two, where is it located? Number three, who were part of the British expedition to Mount Everest in 1953? Number four, who led the expedition? Number five, on which date did the first team leave to reach the summit of Mount Everest? Number six, how far were the first team from the summit when they were forced to return back? Number seven, write the date and time of the second team's departure from camp to start their climb. Number eight, why were Hillary and Norgay delayed? Number nine, what is the name of the difficult rock face that the two men came upon? Number 11, at what time did the second team finally reach the summit? Number 11, write any two activities that Hillary and Norgay engaged in once they reached the summit. Number 12, look at the route map of Hillary and Tenzing on page 24 and write the names of the glaciers they encountered upon. Now let us discuss the questions one by one. Question number one, which is the highest mountain peak in the world? This question you will, this answer you will write on your own. Number two, where is it located? Answer, Mount Everest is a peak in the Himalayan mountain range. It is located between Nepal and Tibet. Question number three, who were part of the British expedition to Mount Everest in 1953? Number four, who led the expedition? Question number five, on which date did the first team leave to reach the summit of Mount Everest? Now question number three, four and five, these three you will do on your own. Question number six, how far were the first team from the summit when they were forced to return back? Answer, the first team was only about 300 feet short of the summit when they were forced to return back. I repeat, the first team was only about 300 feet short of the summit when they were forced to return back. Number seven, write the date and the time of the second team's departure from camp to start their climb. This question again you can do on your own. Number eight, why were Hillary and Norgay delayed? Answer, Hillary and Norgay were delayed because just when they got ready to leave camp, Hillary discovered that his boots had frozen and spent 2 hours defrosting them. I repeat, Hillary and Norgay were delayed because just when they got ready to leave camp, Hillary discovered that his boots had frozen and spent 2 hours defrosting them. Question number nine, what is the name of the difficult rock face that the two men came upon? Question number 10, at what time did the second team finally reach the summit? Okay, now these two questions again you will write on your own. Question number 11, write any two activities that Hillary and Norgay engaged in once they reached the summit. Hillary and Norgay were overjoyed and hugged each other. They spent their time taking photographs and enjoyed the view. Norgay placed a food offering to God. Again, I'm repeating. Number one, Hillary and Norgay were overjoyed and hugged each other. Number two, they spent their time taking photographs and enjoying the view. Number three, Norgay placed a food offering to God. Oh, so out of these three, you can write any two activities that they engaged in. Question number 12. Look at the route map of Hillary and Tenzing on page 24 and write the names of the glaciers they encountered upon. Again, this question you can do on your own. Before I move on to the next set of questions, I shall repeat the questions B, okay? So it is easier for you to follow. Answer the following questions. Question number one, write about the experience of the first team that set out to reach the summit of Mount Everest. Answer, the first team that included Tom Bodilon and Charles Evans left on May 26, 1953 to reach the summit of Mount Everest. They successfully made it to the South Summit, the first ascent of 8,750 meters, coming within 100 meters of the final top, still the highest any human being had ever reached. However, they were forced to return as they faced bad weather problems with their oxygen canister and lack of time. They were also really very tired. Again, I'm repeating this answer. The first team that included Tom Bodilon and Charles Evans left on May 26, 1953 to reach the summit of Mount Everest. They successfully made it to the South Summit, the first ascent of 8,750 meters, coming within 100 meters of the final top, still the highest any human being had ever reached. However, they were forced to return back as they faced bad weather, problems with their oxygen canister, and lack of time. They were also really very tired. Okay, next question. Write a short note on Edmund Hillary. Answer. Sir Edmund Percival Hillary was a New Zealand mountaineer, explorer, and philanthropist. A philanthropist is a person who seeks to promote the welfare of other people, especially by donating money for good causes. On 29th May 1953, Hillary and Sherpa mountaineer Tenzing Norgay became the first climber to have reached the summit of Mount Everest. They were a part of the 9th British expedition to Everest. He was born on 28th July 1919. He was knighted in 1953. Many other honors were bestowed on him, throughout which he maintained a high level of humility, and his main interest came to be the welfare of the Himalayan people of Nepal, especially the Sherpas. He built schools and hospitals and airfields for them. And in 2003, he was made the honorary citizen of Nepal. He died at the age of 88 and on January 11, 2008. Again, I am repeating this answer. Sir Edmund Percival Hillary was a New Zealand mountaineer, explorer, and philanthropist. A philanthropist is a person who seeks to promote the welfare of other people, especially by donating money for good causes. On 29th May 1953, Hillary and Sherpa mountaineer Tenzing Norgay became the first climbers to have reached the summit of Mount Everest. They were a part of the 9th British expedition to Everest. He was born on 28th July 1919. He was knighted in 1953. Many other honors were bestowed on him, throughout which he maintained a high level of humility, and his main interest came to be the welfare of the Himalayan people of Nepal, especially the Sherpas. He built schools and hospitals and airfields for them. In 2003, he was made the honorary citizen of Nepal. He died at the age of 88 and on January 11, 2008. I think you have followed these two questions well. So now we will move on to the next set of questions. Complete the following sentences. Number one, Anna Zerbinska became the oldest woman to reach the summit at the age of dash. Number two, Arjun Vajpal became the youngest Indian to reach the summit on dash at the age of dash. Number three, the first team were forced to turn back dash. And number four, Hillary and Norge's climb was delayed because dash. This objective and the next two objectives that I give you, you shall do on your own. So I will only read them out for you. Next question, choose the correct answer and fill in the gaps. Number one, dash led the expedition. Tenzing Norgay, Charles Evans, or Colonel John Hunt. Number two, the first team made it up to about dash short of the summit. 1000 feet, 300 feet, or 50 feet. Number three, the difficult rock face is now known as Hillary step, Norgay step, or Evans step. Number four, Norgay placed a dash to God. Bouquet of flowers, gift, or food offering. Next question. What happened on May 29th, 1953? Given below is a list of timings. Write the events that took place in these particular time sequence. Number 1, 4 a.m. Number 2, 6:30 a.m. Number 3, 11:30 a.m. And number 4, 11:45 a.m. So as I told you, exercise D, E and F, the last three objectives that I gave you, you will do on your own. Now we shall do a little bit of grammar. Let us revise verbs today. As we already know, a verb is a word which shows action. It is an essential part of the predicate. For example, Javed kicked the ball. This shopkeeper sells books. The peon rings the bell. Words like kicked, sells, and rings express action. They are verbs. Let us now begin with the first exercise. The words in the word box are washed, played, dove, slept, read, solved, climbed, hiked, examined, sang, found, listened. So question number A. Use the verbs from the box to complete each sentence appropriately. Number one, Isabel dashed the song beautifully. Number two, we dashed the mystery of the missing cookies. Number three, Mike dashed the trail from the beginning to the end. Number four, Marcus was very tired after he dashed the peak of the mountain. Number five, the doctor dashed his patient quickly. Number six, the children dash at the playground. Number seven, Mom dashed my football uniform last night. Number eight, the girls dashed the concert intently. Number nine, I dashed that book last week. Number 10, the dog dashed peacefully through the night. So this exercise and the following exercise which I give you, you will do on your own. B. Rewrite the sentences after matching the nouns with the verbs given in the next column and underline the verbs. So what I will first do is read out the words in column A and then I will read out the words in the next column. And what you will do is straight away you will write the answer in the sentence form. Number 1. In column A, number 1, the nightingale. Number 2, the boy. Number 3, the lion. Number 4, the priests. And number 5, the children. Now I'm reading out the words that are there in column B. Played in the rain, prayed for rain, yelled for help, sang sweetly, roared loudly. Next, we move on to the next exercise. Again, the following two exercises you will do on your own, and I shall just read them out for you. C. Add E to make verbs from the following nouns. Number 1, breath. Number 2, clock. Number 3, bit. Number 4, bath. Number 5, life. In this word life, you will change the F and you will replace it with V. Next, question D. Add EN to make verbs from the following nouns. Number 1, dark. Number 2, deep. Number 3, moist. Number 4, weak. And number 5, soft. Words that help us to say or assert what a person or thing is, they are called being verbs. So, being verbs are is, am, are, was, were, be, being, been, they are all being verbs. Being verbs are they often have an adjective after them. For example, the king was kind, I am at home, she is not at home in the morning. Our friends were on their summer holidays, we are from Spain. So now we move on to the next exercise, which you shall again do on your own, but I am reading it out for you. Fill in the blanks correctly with was or were. Number 1, John dash a little child. Number 2, Dave dash playing football. Number 3, yesterday we dash not at home. Number 4, my friend dash absent yesterday. Number 5, all my friends dash invited to my birthday party. Number 6, I dash late to school. Number 7, it dash my father's cell phone. Number 8, I dash born in 1997. Number 9, the books dash expensive. Number 10, the exercise dash easy. Number 11, Tom dash the funny kid in class. Number 12, she dash jealous of her sister's toys. Number 13, they dash rich, but they dash sad. Next exercise again you will do on your own. Complete these sentences with is, am, or are. Number 1, he dash an honest person, so people love him. Number 2, Tom dash very similar to his brother. Number 3, these flowers dash really beautiful. Number 4, Jim dash a very careless driver. Number 5, you dash almost 6 feet tall. Number 6, I think I dash like an eagle. Number 7, Korean cars dash cheap. Number 8, I dash sorry about my mistake. And number 9, Iran dash not in Europe. Number 10, why dash you so sad? Number 11, mother dash in the kitchen preparing dinner. Number 12, dash your parents at home. Number 13, what dash your field of interest? Number 14, the club dash behind the train station. And number 15, it dash cold outside today. Now some verbs show belonging or possession, like has, have and had. They denote belonging. For example, the elephant has a trunk. I have a new pen. Rina had long hair when she was a small girl. Next exercise, we move on to the next exercise, which again you will do on your own. Fill in the blanks correctly with has, have or had. Number 1, our teacher dash a new purse. Number 2, my friend dash a bag. Number 3, Amar dash a brother and a sister. Number 4, I wish we dash a car. Number 5, you dash nice shirts. Number 6, the boys dash a cricket bat. Number 7, the girls dash a party yesterday. Number 8, dash you seen a whale. Number 9, what time do I dash to get up in the morning? And number 10, Ivan dash 6 marbles. Now, some verbs are called auxiliary or helping verbs. Helping verbs or auxiliary verbs help the main verb to describe action. Is, am, are, where, was, do, does, did, has, have, had, be, being, may, might, must, can, could, shall, should, will, would are all helping verbs. So we move on to the next exercise, which again you will do on your own. Now listen carefully. Choose the correct word and complete the sentences given below. Number 1. Do or did you shut the door when you left? Number 2. I like the pink guavas best. Did or do you? Number 3. What did or do you did or do when the monkey entered your room? Number 4. How do or does this tune sound? Number 5. I did or does not did or do it. He does or did it. Number 6. Jamal does or did not go to school yesterday. Number 7. Does or do you know how to spell Constantinople? Number 8. Mr. Nair do or does not have eggs for breakfast. Number 9. Do or does he need a new shirt? Number 10. Did, do or does he do, did or does it on purpose? Okay. So next exercise, again I'm reading it out for you and you will do on your own. Underline the verbs in the following sentences. Number 1. They were very good friends. Number 2. Who will guide us in our work? Number 3. The queen had a magic mirror. Number 4. Throw the ball to me. 5. It uses them for self-defense. Number 6. We should do breathing exercise regularly. Number 7. Mr. Banerjee has got at least 3 big cars. Number 8. We have purchased a new DVD player. Number 9. Her teachers are very happy with her progress. Number 10. The ostrich has powerful long legs. Number 11. Last night we had a delicious dinner at Hotel King. Number 12. You must swim at this beach today. Number 13. They need some important information from the internet. Number 14. These students are going to the computer lab. Number 15. Look up and you will see the top of tall palm trees. Okay. We shall move on to the next exercise. And again, this exercise also you will do on your own. Use the following words both as nouns and as verbs. First, I shall read out the words in the box. Bank, book, train, ring, sink, express, coach, color, spring, present. Number 1. The dash left the station on time. Dash your boys to have better manners. Number 2. Your paper boat will dash in the water. And the next sentence is, go to the dash to brush your teeth. Number 3. The ugly frog lived on the dash of the river. And the next sentence, we must not dash on others but depend on ourselves. Number 4. I must buy a dash for the Basus before I visit them. Next sentence, I will dash them with the gift as soon as I enter the house. Number 5. Cinderella's dash was pulled by 4 white horses. Next sentence, the instructor dashed the boys well before the match. Number 6. After winter comes the beautiful dash. My dog will dash upon the man. Number 7. My favorite dash is pink. Next sentence. The dash the sea is blue and the mountains brown. Number 8. We dash our gratitude for your kind hospitality. Next sentence. The dash arrived at the station before time. Number 9. Prince Charming gave the princess a diamond dash. Give me a dash at 9 a.m. and make the appointment, please. Number 10. My favorite story dash is Treasure Island. Next sentence. Dash a room for me at the Grand Hotel, please. Okay, so all these exercises that I read out in grammar, you will do on your own. I hope you have enjoyed learning with me today, and thank you.